gonna do another video here at El Mirage, only this time we'll do it horizontal, letterbox, and then we'll do it, and I'll also move it around and describe some other things. One of the neat things, and you can hardly see it over there, is there's a cinder cone off in that direction, and it's like mine tailings. We're looking into the sun here, but it's basically about six, seven miles long and a couple miles wide, and then it narrows down at this end. It does get pretty wide open up here. Most of the Mirage action happens in the other direction.
Lines where you get in line and you wait in line to have your run, but you get the whole track to yourself, and there's, you know, ambulances and pickup crews, and you have to bring your own too. But here it is, I'm making a U-E, and so anyway, to our left, like I say, that's where there's like a mile long row, and then wrapped around registration and going up this way to the right side, it's always a lot less. So that's where we're doing it. Now, I'm going to head back down there. So this is kind of the view that I would have if I was accelerating out of the gate. And I'm looking right at this mountaintop, which looks like a very good place. And I'm going to watch some people. obviously pay better attention now rather than being a spectator.
Before, oh yeah, there's the cinder cone. You can see it kind of well.
So I'm going 45 now. So I'm guessing this would be the run where I'll be going 140, or maybe it's a little more over here. You know, that's just it. I don't even know. Until they lay down the cones. But that's it. They'll do a walk. They'll find a good spot. And people walk it, and they patch any of the really big potholes. And I guess they spritz them and, even it out. And it's you're basically, you know, it's legal to do just about anything out here, I guess. People do a lot of hand glider, ultralights, and like I said, UTVs, ATVs.
Yeah, this might here might be where the this is beginning to look familiar. This might be where the starting line is. Yeah, like right there. Wonder if that line is it. That could be the starting line, because this is beginning to look familiar. This is near where we camp. Yeah, I'm doing about 70 now.
Yeah, this is nice. This is like pavement. This is in good shape. That's because this is far out in the middle. People just kind of stick to the edges. Because it is, it's like a no man's land out here. You know, it really is.
My poor trailer is getting blasted with dust. The inside of the trailer is probably going to be filled with dust. I'm sure that thing is, they say it's watertight, and it is, but dustproof isn't. That's from the bottom. Uh-oh. Who knows? We'll find out later. Once again, for posterity, making the video.
Yeah, so if you never get a chance to get to El Mirage, or experience this. I mean, never mind the spiritual nature of just the high desert, the mountains, that California thing that we don't get back east. There's the lake bed, which is a geological oddity. Not really, they're actually quite common out here. High plateaus that have floodplains between young mountains. Anyway. Getting rough again on that same spot. Okay, so this is now 8 minutes. So what did I say? That was 3.5 before? Alright, so there you go. So there's a good 3.5 miles of good smooth stuff. That must be where they obviously select the 2.x miles they dedicate to the course. And just so you get a feel for how disorienting it can be just to try to get out of here, is, you know, you have to look for the road. And it just isn't always that obvious. Anyway, that's the end of my video.